guys, what's up? It's Hope. Today is Thursday, June 14th, 2018, and I'm here to bring you a really quick update. I know in my last video, I said that we're just pretty much waiting for the baby to pick his birth date, and that is still very much the case. We are nearing 37 weeks tomorrow, and I went to the doctor yesterday for an update, and so I wanted to make sure and just log on real quick and document how this week's appointment went, and just to kind of talk a little bit about where we're at in the process and kind of where we're headed moving forward. He is still very, very happy where he is. I am not dilated whatsoever. There is no progress at all. He is still very high, which makes me really excited because I was super nervous that he would come early, but it's looking like he'll probably come around his due date, which is June 29th. Because I'm not progressing any and I'm not contracting and there's really nothing happening, it's very quiet. They don't expect him to come early, which I'm super grateful for. I've had so many people ask me, are you miserable? It's so hot. I mean, I live in Texas. It was like 104 yesterday. And I'm not miserable. I'm just trying to soak in every single moment I possibly can. Every time he moves or kicks or has the hiccups, I just literally sit in silence and just feel it and thank God for it. I've been so grateful for this experience and I'm just really kind of sad that we're nearing the end of it. So I had an appointment yesterday and everything looked great. His heart rate was 143. His heart rate was 143 beats per minute, which is normal. Typically it's anywhere from like 141 to like 145. And so he was perfectly fine. We are going to do another ultrasound next week because my doctor is still worried about his size. And so we're going to do an ultrasound just so she can kind of get an estimate of how big he's going to be or how big he is right now to determine when she thinks he may or may not be coming. So I'm still really worried about his size, but at this point, I'm just grateful to have made it this far. I know he's healthy. I know everything has checked out okay. He's just really comfortable in there and there's just no activity going on. So I'm just kind of grateful for that. I'm grateful that I still get to experience this and that I've had this incredible opportunity to carry him this far. So but the appointment went great. Like I said, I'm going every week now, and so they checked me and no activity, nothing going on. So I'll go back next week for another appointment and another ultrasound. Which I'm excited about because not a lot of women get a whole bunch of ultrasounds, and I feel like we've gotten quite a few. So I'm excited to see him one more time before he's actually here. I can't believe we're at that point where he could literally come any day now. So that's just unbelievable. I'm feeling so much better these days. I don't know if I talked about my last video, but they found out that I was anemic, and so I've been taking an iron supplement, and it has helped so much with the fatigue. I feel so much better, like a completely different person. And so that is something that's definitely changed over the last couple of weeks. I have a lot more energy during the day. I'm not dragging or tired as I yawn. I'm not dragging or tired. Now when it gets to be probably around 6:30 in the evening, I can definitely feel like, okay, I've had my fill. I need to lay down. I need to prop my feet up. I need to get off of my feet and rest. And so, but during the day, I'm feeling a lot better, which I am so excited about. It was so hard. If you would have asked me in the middle of May, if I thought I was going to make it to June, I would have said no. The fatigue was just so bad, but I'm feeling really great and I'm excited. I'm nervous. I just can't wait to see him and meet him and see what he looks like. All the things. I can't wait for all of the things. And so I'm still very swollen. That's kind of been a given this entire time. My feet and legs are still pretty swollen. So I'm trying to prop them up as much as I possibly can. But everything else is just going great. My blood pressure has been awesome, which I'm grateful for. And so at this point, we're kind of just waiting on him, which is a very, very, very just bittersweet kind of moment. Like, I'm excited for him to come, but then I'm sad about my pregnancy ending. It's kind of like Christmas morning in a really large life scale kind of way. And so, I don't know, I'm just trying to soak it in. Tomorrow is actually my last day of work, officially. We have made the decision for me to be able to stay home, and I'm excited, but I'm nervous. And I cannot wait to be able to experience all the moments that I've prayed and hoped that I would be able to experience someday with him. And so I'm excited for it. Like I said, I'm nervous. I've always worked. I love my job. I love what I do. But at the end of the day, you know, I've wanted to be a mom. That was my lifelong dream, and here it is. And so, I will be packing up my office today, and tomorrow is my last official day. And then hopefully I'll have next week to get our house ready. Our house should be done by this weekend. Thank you, Lord. I'm hoping and praying it will be. And we've been in contact with our contractor, and he's still saying we're right on schedule. So I'm hoping that we can have someone come in and clean this weekend and then start moving everything in next week. And so it'll be nice to have some time off from work to go ahead and try to get everything set up for our house and for his nursery. Everything that's been gifted to us or given to us or donated, or people have just been giving to the baby, and we have everything in storage right now. So I'm excited to get everything out and start going through it and washing it and getting it ready for him. That's another reason why I'm excited he's kind of holding on, so that way I can try to get everything ready before he gets here. I mean, obviously I know if he comes we'll be fine, but I would love to have everything ready before he gets here. So I will go ahead and let y'all go for now. I will continue to keep you updated. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.